Fabric Club in London is well known far beyond the borders of the United Kingdom. It's seen as one of the best addresses for progressive electronic music. The club's located in Farringdon, an area clearly marked by the Victorian era, and which developed into a largely business district after World War II. Hence, the area seemed quite deserted at the weekends. That stopped in 1999, when after a rather long planning and construction phase, Fabric opened its doors in a former meat market close to the tube station in Farringdon. Today, Farringdon is crowded with people in the street by day and by night. The club has really revived the area. On three levels, the club offers a rather intimate atmosphere with many rooms and corridors branching off. Its overall size is 2,300 square meters with a capacity for 1,500 people. Opening times aren't exactly set in stone. Officially, it opens Fridays, Saturdays and Sundays from 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. Unofficially, it sometimes stays open longer. And if you don't like queuing, you should come very, very, very early. Policy on the door is relaxed. The managers care about music, not about certain dress codes or other scene-affiliated attitudes. Hence, you get in if you out yourself as a music lover and don't attract attention by aggressive behaviour. And you should definitely have a valid ID on you.
The door policy. Well, we need ID. If you got no valid ID, driver's license and a passport, that's only two forms of ID that we do take. Because you get people with a fake college ID, which they produce on the internet, £20. We don't do that. Oh, got to be driver's license and a passport. We're fairly relaxed on the door. We're not heavy-handed.
Hi.
Hi. Upstairs, please. This is nothing. This is
nothing.
Yeah. We can't have them going in drunk. They can get drunk inside. Then we let them get a coffee. But no drunks from outside for us. You must sober up to satisfy us. Otherwise, the medic's got a lot of work to do. Young lady. Young lady. Young lady. This way, please, ladies.
Thank you.
Good evening. Upstairs, please. I'm just being myself, so. It helps people to relax. They go in and have a good time, and they come and say, "Hi." He's still here laughing and joking. But I find it's a lot easier for me and for the other guys as well. Because people that come in, they relax. They're not like, got the aggressive doorman and door, so they're coming aggressive towards the bar staff. And kind of filters down, I find. If you're aggressive here, it'll go wrong all night.
On the three dance floors, you can expect a musical mix of techno, house, dubstep, and drum and bass. What's on when and on which floor depends on the evening's lineup. An absolute highlight of the club is the bass-controlled dance floor, the first system of its kind in Europe. The vibration of the low frequencies is transmitted into the dancers' bodies via their feet. That creates a unique music feeling. You're practically steeping in bass and start vibrating yourself. In the futuristic interior of the club, you look in vain for visuals or spectacular light shows. Optic effects are kept at a minimum. It's all about the music here. We'll be right back. smoking in official buildings has recently become illegal. There's a special smokers area outside the club, a rather popular place. You might even have to queue to get in there. Every week you can meet the who's who of the international DJs and live acts in Fabric. Anyone who's anyone plays here. Craig Richards, Terry Francis, Richie Horton, Ricardo Villalobos, Plump DJs, Adam Freeland, Scratch Perverts, Andy C, Groove Rider, the list goes on and on.
I guess it's been open nearly 8 years now, and we've always tried to book as diversely as possible and try to represent things equally. You know, meant to be a platform for underground music, and we've tried to keep it as varied as possible and be as sensitive as possible to people that are around, coming through, new people. And we're in a good position now. In the beginning it was harder to sort of put people on, but now we're in a good position where we can put people on that perhaps the audience hasn't heard of, and they'll respond to it and receive it. I think we've just been fairly sort of responsible to what we like. You know, that's how we book, really. We just book what we like, from sort of old school stuff to new things, and the combination, the juxtaposition of those things is really interesting. I think having an established artist with a new live act or a new artist is exciting, and also things that don't necessarily go together often somehow work. You know, people are in the club for a long time, and it's good to hear different things throughout the night. You've got three rooms where they can walk around, and it's just different flavours. If you're going to be somewhere for sort of 7, 8, 9 hours, it's nice to be able to experience as much music as possible, presented properly with decent sound systems, and as I say, all pitched the same way, no importance given to any one thing, really. If there's anything that we've done, it's been that. We've exposed really, really great music to a larger audience and given it a proper platform. And I think that's been our task. That's what we wanted to do, and if anything, I think we've achieved that. You know, I think people have always really, they've understood very early on that they get what they're given. You know, we're not pandering to what they want, really. It's not a case of sort of serving the public in that way. When I'm DJing, I'm not thinking about that, and I'm playing here every week, you know, and I'm just not really interested in pandering to the whims of the public. You know, it may sound a bit arrogant, but it's just not really where we're coming from, and I think people have got a greater understanding of what we present to them, and they're willing to absorb it, and it's a better place to be. You know, they're willing to dance till dawn, you know, to whatever we put on, which is a great spot for us.
There's a special called Fabric First, which grants you membership and certain advantages.
Fabric First is basically the membership what's come from the Fabric Club. You pay £6 a month, you get a CD every month, which is an absolute bargain. Even in the shops, it's over a tenner. And for £6, you get the CD, then you get the benefits, all the online streaming, all the sets what we record from the site. And then if you're London-based, you get money off and a queue jump to the club, which is all good, because the queues are fucking massive.
The Fabric Mix CD is very popular, It's also sold in the shops, but there you'll have to pay regular prices. Proper long party, get yourself to Farringdon. It's always worth a visit.
Have that side, please. Have that side, please.